coming to you live on your chin. Oh, kid. Oh. This is the Goin Deep Show.
Let's go!
You ready? You ready?
Hail Satan, Satan, praise the Dark Lord.
Fighting for the powers of ether,
because good is dumb.
It's Goin Deep Show time. Hi, it's me, the kid. Let's do it. Joining me, LB.
Cold as fuck out.
And the only one whose nipples are probably just standing straight up at attention. Mine aren't. I got them contained.
Facts are facts.
There you go. Let me turn you
on. Facts are facts.
Let me turn you on, Fiona, with your nipples.
Turn me on.
Turn her up. Turn her on.
Turn me on now.
It's Goin Deep Show time, guys. It's going to be an extended episode, 30 minutes, back to the old school ways of doing things here, just for time and frames and things like this. Today's episode, we're going to talk about whores.
Who is?
We're going to talk about Snapchats, the modern day relationship, and stuff to clean your wang. Can you believe it? Stuff to clean
Bonerville.
Your wang.
Not tanning lotion.
Yes, it does not work well. I mean, it works, but.
Stuff to clean your ding dong. That's how it's going to be. I'm on these dating apps, so I get all these solicitations from all these bitches. Now, I love getting these because I just grind my gears. Okay, these fucking dumb whores, and that's literally what they are. They're hookers. They are hookers on these apps.
Have you actual prostitutes?
Actual prostitutes, 100% prostitutes.
Like Sir Mix-a-Lot would be singing their praises.
Oh yeah.
Rapping their praises.
They start every conversation with, "What city are you in?" And then magically, they're right in the same city too. Can you believe it? Then it's, "Do you want to see my rates?" I'm like, "Do you want to see my rates?"
My mind's telling me no,
but my body,
my body's telling me yes.
Yikes.
So I seriously will respond with the same thing. Because it's just like, I love the fact that it's this pussy on a pedestal thing. Why does a woman think that they can charge a dude
For the same fucking thing.
Literally. Clean. Literally the same thing.
Literally.
So we're easily entertained today, I can tell. It's fine. I love it, man.
I'm hoping you replay some of that bump and grind just in honor of them.
I was gonna try to find.
He'll play that when you show us.
Or hoes in different area codes.
Hoes in the codes, man. So I'm trying to find this the last one that solicited me because it's so entertaining to read what I send back to these fucking whores. I will berate them like crazy. I'm like, "You realize you're a whore, right?" I say all this shit. They just
blocked.
No, yeah, it's so bad. I'm totally evil with these dumb hookers, and it's seriously. I'm not even joking. How bad it is. You've never had this bad before on Snapchat?
No, I usually just Snapchat people that I know.
I want to see these girls' butts and shit, though. I mean, how do you
want to see? Mind's telling me no.
Ooh, yeah.
But my body's telling me yes. Baby, I don't want to hurt nobody. But there is something that I must confess.
I won't see. Wait a minute.
Bring on the devil.
I don't see nothing wrong.
The wind of
I don't see nothing wrong with it. Wait. Sounds like a bit of pussy here. That's what these girls' pussy sound like.
Hello in there.
No, but seriously.
Run across one of your old homies.
Why do women think that they can put this pussy on a pedestal? Do you do this with your pussy?
They've been doing it for thousands of years, man.
Fiona, do you put your pussy on a pedestal?
Not hardly, because I don't give a fuck.
Do you appreciate the dick as much as the guys appreciate your pussy?
Naturally.
You think?
Literally.
I think you have to do that, I think. It's equal. Red years ago tried it one time with me. If you do the dishes, we can have sex.
No.
How about this? I'll go lay in bed, you wrap up, and then come back, and then you can have exactly what I would have exactly the same time. It's just like when you hold chores over me to get some fucking pussy. Like, it's like, no. I'm gonna go jerk off, go to bed, bye.
No, that's one of those things. That's one of those things where, like, she doesn't really give a fuck if she gets it or not. If she does, yay. If she doesn't, whatever.
But this happens. Women think it's like a prize, I think.
Yeah, you can't do that.
I used to do that.
It's not the pussy that's the prize. It's the fucking nut that's the prize.
Mm-hmm.
Am I wrong?
I have a feeling, dude, I'm getting concerned with my jerk off routine.
Why?
You have no idea.
Why?
I can't get into any one genre right now where I feel like I need to, like, really take a break from it.
I'm getting numb to porn.
Genre? You mean, like,
I'm getting numb to it because I typically, you know, typically.
You mean like bondage?
You tend to watch a lot of the same shit because you know what you're into, and it's like, I just need something new.
You mean like bondage versus I fucked my stepmother?
Yeah.
Right now, the only thing that gets me off right now, it seems to be the compilations where there's like multiple women and it's just fucking, they're just getting their faces glazed, man. And they're just like, just fucking like you're at the donut factory. Just
Jesus.
It's just, I don't know what it is, man. Is there something about a woman just like,
cops and donuts.
This is what I saw one today, just today. It's two chicks. And Peter North, right? I've showed you Peter North before here on the screen. And he, the one girl, it was almost like a contest, like a race. Okay? So Peter North, what are you looking at? What's going on over here?
My dad's calling.
Oh, your dad's calling.
Right in the middle.
I'm not bringing him in on this. Not yet.
So here's the thing. Peter North is with two chicks, and they're it's like a race. You can tell that the girls are competing. Like, who's going to get it? Hot potato, here we go. You know what I mean?
Yeah,
one girl gets it, but the girl...
Like, who's going to get the load in the
face? Who's going to get the load? Okay? Because they both they both wanted the load. Really attractive chick doesn't get load, and you could see the disappointment in her eyes. Like, it was like...
Like, she's disappointed.
Her little tears in her eyes, her little low lips just quivering.
It was like, my sister got a new bike, and I didn't get one. That was the only thing I could describe. It was hilarious watching her. And then at one point, I remember her after he had done, blasted all over her face. She like reaches over and she's like she wants a little bit. She like reaches over and grabs it, just takes the leftovers.
Oh, for fuck's sake, you pathetic piece of shit.
It was
just a little candy, you know?
It was awesome. It was awesome watching this.
I'm just going to take the sloppy seconds.
But there's something about the desire in her eyes, man, that's hot. It was just as hot watching her like long for the dick in the fucking load as it was the chick getting in the face. It was. It was like hot. I kind of want to take a screen grab just of the disappointment in her face. It was just so bad.
That's just a porn thing. I'm sorry. It's just a fucking porn thing. Like, I don't sit there longing for a load in my fucking face.
Right.
Like, oh, I don't give a fuck about the rest of it. Just fucking.
I guess the money shot.
Spooey all over me.
I could care less. You know, on the money shot. Like, for me, it doesn't really do anything.
I don't know.
I mean, I get the idea of it and whatnot.
Yeah.
I've been hooked on this freaking broad, Lisa Rowe. Lisa Rowe. Like, L-I-Z-A. R-O-W-E, like, for all you guys going to go up and look it out.
Liza Rowe.
Liza Rowe, yeah, it's probably what it is, but I don't know what, she's just something.
So if you're getting immune to this at what point is nothing, like at what point, like what is going to, like where's the means to the end?
Yeah, like, well, you start searching new shit. You start looking into new shit.
You start looking into like.
It's either like, because I don't want to go out and whore around right now. It's like, I haven't, you know what I mean? I haven't been just about that kind of life.
Literally.
And, like, literally.
Like the same.
And so like, you know, you stay at home at night and you fucking, you're like, oh, I got to rub one out. But my imagination's fucking shot, man.
There's
nothing left up there. You know what I mean? I got nothing. All right.
It's true.
Got nothing left. So, you know, you find something. You pretty much got like three.
What is there, fucking like
three websites
and
rotation.
And shit? You're like, oh, let's watch Disney.
Yeah. That's right. Ariel. Where's that redhead at?
Them shells
like under
them
the
titties.
Sea, bitch.
You got to go back to the regular mags and shit. Porno mags.
Like back when I was a teenager?
Yeah, you reminisce, man. Do a little retro.
Start looking at the Sears catalog.
Dude, I only have so many hands. You know what I mean? Flip pages.
You're like sitting
stroke my shit.
Licking your thumb flip.
Right, and at that time, I probably got a handful of fucking tanning lotion. You know what I mean? So the pages are sticking together. It's just a fucking mess, seriously.
I don't
beating off's almost more work than what it's worth anymore.
I don't come across that problem.
Last night, I did not do that. I woke up with a fucking tent, pitching a goddamn tent. Yeah.
Well, that means your shit works.
It's working. It's working okay.
You don't need to worry about that.
But... Yeah,
I could put nails in with this fucker most days, especially in the morning, like you're talking.
Usually, you know? It's like I got a couple in me early on, then I beat the shit out of that thing, get rid of that, and go on with the day.
He's bringing the hammer.
But dude, since COVID, my sex drive has dropped. Since I got sick, I don't get horned up like naturally. Like throughout the day, I would, you know, just all of a sudden be thinking about it, and get turned on, or whatever.
Is it problem?
Seriously, and then yeah. I got sick. And like when I was sick, there was nothing. That thing was a dead fucking fish in the water, you know?
Yeah.
But then afterwards, I'm all like, it'll come back. So I noticed like getting into the gym helps.
Just be glad. Yeah. Just be glad it was fucking, you know, the one kind and not the butthole other.
Oh, yeah.
You know what I found tantalizing me a little bit is when a woman out of nowhere sends a fucking unsolicited pic.
I had this happen
on Bumble yesterday. Just yesterday, some girl that I had just talked to, and I'm not even. She sends me
roast beef.
She goes, "It's freezing cold here this morning," and I sent back like nipple hardening, and boom, titty pic. All I said was nipple hardening cold, and she goes, "Yeah, these are on attention all the time." And I'm like, "Oh, hello."
You got no problems, kid.
Yeah, she laying it out there.
Yeah, she threw it out there. I don't even know how I connected with this chick. She's like in Wisconsin or some shit. I don't even remember liking her.
Well,
I don't know. Must have switched your mileage to what, 400 miles?
God.
He's reaching out there.
He's
man,
like I just don't give a fuck.
I don't want to. Right. I don't want to do this.
Just need something for the spank bank?
But this is like the modern day relationship, though. It really is. You know? It's like kind of like psychological warfare, almost. You're sending little subtle messages through all these different routes of things. And we talked about this the other day.
Yeah.
About your accidental sending into that group chat.
It was actually...
As soon as I seen that shit, I'm all like, yeah.
It actually...
How nice.
How did I explain it to you?
She does a search on your name, which I feel very proud of that, LB.
What?
Because when she goes to do that group chat...
I always type you
Yeah,
in.
You should have deleted that group fucking a month ago.
There's funny shit on there still.
I don't go
that
back
that
into
I share
that
with coworkers.
Oh, do you?
Yeah.
Like, oh, all right.
Yeah.
Well, all right.
So I always type...
I get that.
When
yeah.
I'm sending to the group, I always type in your name.
See, what you need to do is you need to name the group. I named my, you know what my group's called? That one that we don't use it. We don't use quotation marks anymore.
Yeah.
I call it shenanigans.
Right. Uh-huh.
So when you guys start texting on the wrong group and it says shenanigans, I know we're on the wrong fucking group.
Okay.
I mean,
so I need to name it.
So it was,
yeah, name it and then you'll know which one you got.
So it was done accidentally.
It was. And then I sent and I was like.
Allegedly.
I'll believe that when me shit turned purple and tastes like rainbow sherbet.
It was done accidentally initially, and then I laughed and I went, oh well.
Allegedly.
Yes. I was waiting for it. I was waiting for
and
it.
And to be perfectly honest with you, I think the episode was listened to. Which is fucking
well, because yeah, what comments were made in a conversation?
Here's what made it fishy.
No, nobody said shit.
Oh, do you want to know what made it fishy to me?
You would know.
When's the last time you posted one of the shows back through the feed or through the chat like that?
I didn't even know who was on it. I thought it was another one of ours because we just did that. Yeah. So I thought we were pushed. I thought
either
that
way.
Would be pushed forward.
Either way,
right.
We like to send messages here.
But
subtle messages through the show. Yeah.
I'm laughing like my fucking ass off.
It's like we talked about at lunch today, you know. We're pouring it on here thick here just to see what's going, just to see what happens, you know.
Oh, it's fucking.
Like syrup?
Yeah, what the fuck? Why not?
Like maple syrup.
I tell you what, maple syrup's a little thicker than that fucking hot tub water the other night, wasn't it?
Before we get into that, I need to follow up with something that we talked about yesterday's show. It was we were getting messages from Mr. Clean's friend Cassie, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Probably shouldn't have used her real name because now he's going to stop fucking sending her messages and
no,
shit
he
like
won't.
This. So she was reaching out and talking about some stuff. The last thing that she
literally
said to me. She said,
"You're fucking welcome."
Yes, literally said, "He's fucking whacked as fuck."
Oh Jesus!
Literally,
that's the last thing she said.
That's the, I feel bad for him a little.
He's a good dude.
He seems all right. I did come to his defense a little bit. And then after she said he's whacked as fuck.
Aww.
I just kind of
probably really.
I left it as is. I didn't because I had tried to explain.
He's a nice guy. Come
throughout
on.
The years, you know. But anyway,
come on now,
Mr. Clean. When you coming back?
I like Clean.
Yeah, he's good shit.
He's always been nice to me.
Mm-hmm.
Always.
Fuck it.
Come back in, motherfucker.
Fuck it.
Always.
Get on the mics.
Let bygones be bygones. Okay, so yeah, we did do some tubbing the other night, didn't we?
Fucking ain't right, we did.
That was a bit nippy out.
That was New Year's. New Year's Eve,
going into New Year's Day, bringing in 2022. Correct.
Absolutely.
I felt kind of bad that we just like hijacked the tub.
That's the thing. That's the thing with Pinkie Pie's fucking hot tub. It's like, you're welcome.
Yeah, right.
Come on in, you're welcome. She doesn't have to be there. She doesn't give a shit.
Come hither.
Just
it
would
have been nice to have them two there. I mean,
we want a slurry
riot
of Mexican balls inside of this hot tub here.
Just don't leave it worse than when you found it.
Right.
She
don't.
She doesn't give a fuck.
That cold weather though doesn't do you any favors. That's for damn.
Doesn't bother me any.
Well, yeah. I bet. Turn your titties into glass cutting.
I don't prefer that kind of weather, but
my dick don't prefer that kind of weather.
We don't have any like Seinfeld episodes.
No, dude. Shivers and shrieks and tries to hide, and it's like, hey,
fucking,
come here, little feller. It's fucking cold.
Clinging to your fucking grundle.
Yeah, seriously. It just like tucks in and wraps my sack around it like a fucking throw blanket. Dude. It's like pigs in a blanket.
You know how it is when you go out just to take a fucking piss here.
Hell yeah.
It's like fucking shit, man. You just go pee outside. You're like, nah, this is not right. There's nothing right about this.
It's like fucking the shit freezes as it exits your fucking dick. Fucking razor blades.
I just give it a shake to snap the icicle off of it every couple of seconds.
Like it doesn't even fucking squirt or dribble or anything like that. It's just like slushy.
Like my fucking drink.
So the girl, the
instant,
the person who we were just talking about with Mr. Clean there, she sent me an image like half hour ago, not of her titties or anything like that. It was this thing called Boner's Penis Cleaner. It made me think that it's an interesting.
Was it gentle on your dick skin?
Specifically for cleaning your dick.
Dong.
So
what about soap?
I don't. This is what I'm thinking. It is like we've read nothing on this, but I'm thinking it's like a waterless car wash. So say you slip off into the cemetery or some parking lot to get your shit waxed. You know what I mean? You know, I'm just saying somewhere around there.
I've never done that either of those before.
So then you're going. You got to go home. So you take this. You give it a little squirt. You rub it on, and then you take a little cloth or, you know, it's somebody's hoodie they left behind, and you give it a little wipe off or something, you know?
I'm more of a church hockey arena kind of guy, banging in those empty parking lots.
I like the nature outlook kind of situation.
I haven't had sex
like
in an odd area in years, dude. Years.
There's Fiona, how about you? What's going on over there? How do you keep warm in these negative degree temperatures while you're riding the...
You just suck in the carbon monoxide from your minivan.
I have stow and go.
Stow and go.
Yeah, stow and go.
I keep the heat on the whole fucking time, man.
Fucking blow and go.
The winter is the worst for doing the car sex thing. I did it for about 3-4 years.
I have zero problems.
And it's like, fuck this, man. Fuck this shit.
Get a minivan. Get a new minivan.
That was one of the funnest things about with the
as a man we
with the orphan.
Get a minivan.
The orphan we had.
You don't have to, but you could fuck anywhere.
Yeah, I've only banged in a minivan like twice. One of them was just a couple months ago.
Yeah. Yeah.
In the middle of a Meijer parking lot. It was.
Jesus.
You can you tint those windows out like mine.
Oh, tinted windows are a must. No
fucking
matter what
limo tint.
My truck, my car, everything's tinted.
You're fucking. You're fucking golden. I'm just saying. Just throwing it out there.
Well, you know when their head doesn't get above the dash. So it doesn't really matter if they're fucking tinted. I know why you got them booster seats in the car. It ain't from your kids, all right? I'm just saying.
Literally.
Hey.
Lord, I'm going to hell.
Hey, God. I don't discriminate. It's not about that. It's about what's in fucking below the belt. I'm just
That's
saying.
That's true. Like
it's
midgets.
It's a low blow. It's a low blow.
It's all about the tripod.
So right. This reminds me of like the other day I had my cock rings out. I used one of my cock rings.
What does that bother? Like that doesn't bother you at all?
Oh no, I love
like,
I love,
like
I love
choking off the fucking.
No, it's not like it's no, it's like got just enough give that when it hope, and there's like three different
hope
sizes.
She doesn't fucking snap it
there's
like a bra
three
strap.
Different sizes.
Yeah, you give
too.
It a kit. I've never bought per se like an actual cock ring kit. But a girl I was dating like 10, 12 years ago, she bought me this thing. I just called it the Terminator.
Oh, yeah.
Because it was stretchy. It was gummy, right?
Yeah.
And at the top of it, it had a fucking bullet. You know what that is?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
The bullet slides into this little mini ring on top of that. and it had this wire with a controller going to it. So you'd wrap it around your balls and your dick like a cotton, right? And it's got this fucking machine on top of it.
Do you wrap it around your balls too?
You can.
You because you know it's stretchy.
I'm learning things, guys.
You hit the button, dude. That my whole dick would just start
turn into
shaking.
A vibrator. Yeah. There's the one I have. The kit that I have has three.
It's a fucking kit.
Three cock rings in it, and the way it shows it on the container,
like a suitcase full of knives.
You put one at the base, you put one mid level, and you can put one at the tip. You can wear all three of them at the same time.
Holy and
I've
shit,
only
never
done
thought about
I've
that.
Only done two at once.
But doesn't that take away from you because it's separating you from the walls of the fucking vagina?
It depends how far. I only did the two, and then they were base and midway up. I didn't do the tip one, so it's
so the head's good and the
perfect.
Head. That, yeah. that's oh, the most yeah. sensitive area.
And it's
anyway.
Like I'm telling you, man. It's like the thickest when you, I remember, oh yeah, it's like, it just makes it, because all the blood is just stuck there.
So you're just fucking pile driving this bitch.
It doesn't come back down until you fucking take the thing off and then it kind of recedes a little bit. But so yeah, when it's all there and you put that fucker on, it's like, here we go.
I said, look at that big motherfucker.
So it doesn't impede flow of load?
No, They're not that
You couldn't
like,
impede that
tight.
With a fucking brick wall. All right?
It's not that tight, no.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
It's got a lot of give to it, yeah.
Well, I did learn something new today.
Yeah.
Cock rings were attached. In fact, the reason I bring it up is because one of the times with the blonde...
recent.
Yeah, yeah.
Not the recent.
Huffy.
Oh, older. Oh, the younger one from years ago.
The bicycle one.
She wanted to try that. She wanted to try the cock ring out, and I went and got the vibrating one.
Mm-hmm. Oh, you had one of those, too?
In the backseat of her car. And yeah, it was fucking awesome. Yeah,
it
was great.
It seemed a bit much sometimes, though. Like,
yeah,
you know. But the thing is like the way that it's built. If you use it right, they get on and ride you. You know, they'll just be dinging that little fucking button against her. Tink, tink.
It's perfect. That's how it's supposed to be.
That's right.
Literally.
God bless Clean for all the entertainment.
So with this cold weather and shit, we've all been layering down with extra layers and whatnot. How layered are you today? Yeah, you got some nice, thick, warm layers.
Long johns. I'm wearing long johns, okay?
I feel like that's a lot.
Yeah.
From my toes to my neck.
Allegedly. Well, that sucks, man.
That's funny that you should ask.
Would you like to elaborate?
Yep.
All right. Let's see these long johns. Yeah, those look real thick and warm.
Looks like fucking dental floss is what it looks like.
Well, it's got a top to it, okay? So, like, I'm not one of your fucking favorites, but, you know.
Oh, all right.
Yeah.
And then
that'll keep you
all the way down.
I mean, it might not keep you warm, but it'll keep me warm. All right,
I'm
just saying.
I'm warm enough, all right.
Yeah,
it actually goes all the way down to my toes.
Oh, it's
full
got
body
leg,
suit,
like
huh?
Full legs and
yeah.
No shit.
Yeah, yeah,
that's
yeah.
Quite.
Is this one of the ones that we picked out?
I think it was. Yeah, it's got. Yeah. Yep.
I'm good for a lot of things.
Is it going crotchless
to the,
or no?
Going to the sex toy shop?
No,
and picking out outfits is one.
It's got so that it's got like the line for the ass. So, you know, like, the ass looks just good. Just so good.
Let's ask Mr. Clean what he has to say about this.
Let's see here. We've got, I don't know what, let's see here.
Thank you, Mr. Clean, for your elaborate.
It's
quite the commentary. Yeah. Holy fuck.
Literally.
It's not easy not having him here to make more soundboards.
Oh, man, I got hours of him.
Yeah, we can make way more.
You're like, I've got years of him.
Yeah. This is perfect, LB. It's like you're looking over my shoulder at my show notes here.
Sex
in the car, coldness, outfit, sex toy cleaner, penis cleaner, modern day relationships, whores. I mean,
this is what good flow is here, man.
This is what it's all about. Let's talk about what she's drinking here and what she's drinking out of. It looks like
an adult-sized Capri Sun.
I am taking this fucker and filling it over and over and over.
Except it was leaking before we even left the damn bar.
I don't think he put the
so
top on.
So was she, but she still showed up.
I don't think he put the top on right. I think, because there's this part.
I don't know. That guy seemed like he was struggling.
There's this part that screws off.
He's a nice dude. I like that guy.
And I think that what he didn't, he didn't take that off. The cock ring.
The cock ring. He didn't take the cock ring off of that thing.
He didn't take that off.
Maybe in the Michigan cold weather, it's
a
cock ring.
And now, hold on.
Oh, now it don't leak.
Yes, there we go, everybody. I love having my soundboards back. This is like a whole thing, man.
It's almost awesome. A show. Almost.
So much
it's
clean.
Awesome.
Fucking awesome.
Awesome.
I'm going to talk about children here to wrap this one up. We only got like another 5 minutes of this bullshit. Here's the thing, okay? Yesterday, I picked the kid up from school, and there is idiots out. And again, I'm going to sound like an old fucking man bringing this up. And he's like, kid, you sound like a grandpa, whatever. But it is like negative fucking degrees out there. It's fucking cold as shit, right?
Yeah.
There was this girl. I swear she was retarded. I'm not even saying like she's just retarded for, you know. I think she had like her. The look on her face was like, she had something fucking wrong with her. And if she didn't have something wrong with her, what the fuck? She was wearing a skirt.
No.
Big skirt that stuck out, right? Barely thigh high, like the thigh high skirt, right?
She's a whore in training.
I know. And in a black, like low cut black shirt, sleeveless shirt.
But
no coat. Bare arms, all from wrist all the way up. Backpack on, though. Very like, what's the fucking
Catholic schoolgirl?
Yes, Catholic schoolgirl look about her.
But oh, I used to have a jumper like that.
Like a retard one, though.
With knee socks.
Remember Aerosmith video? With his daughter in it. That kind of an outfit with the...
I had something like that when I was in high school.
Here's the thing about it, though. This is the funniest fucking thing. As I'm pulling up to leave the damn school, my kid's sitting in the... I cracked her a little bit, because usually she's on like... So I'm always trying to riff. If I can make her laugh, we're good to go. So this kid, this little bitch is with her friends walking up the street, the girl in the skirt. And I said, what in the fuck is up with this? I said, look at this asshole. And watch, her backpack's on. I said, I'll bet you $50 her skirt is pulled up.
It was underneath
the backpack, and her whole fucking ass was just on display, up the fucking street. I'm just like, what the fuck are you doing? What an idiot. Just a fucking moron.
Was that a purposeful thing?
I don't know. I don't think there was something wrong with this girl.
I mean, it was cold outside. She was wearing a skirt, so maybe she didn't actually notice. Because how would you fucking know when you have like a piece of material flapping over your skin that's not attached to you, like
jeans? Her butt and everything was just done.
She would have been better off with shorts.
Her asshole. Just you ever had an embarrassing like moment where somebody catches you, or your fucking titties are out, or your butt's hanging out?
Oh yeah. I went tubing once. I was probably like 13 or 14 or something like that. I went tubing and the water like fucking caught the swimsuit, and so like I got out of the water and I had one of them hanging out, and I'm like, hey, and like my friend's like cousin or whatever the fuck he was, uncle or something like that, he's like
drop your
pointing at his, and then
uncles always notice when titties are hanging out.
And I looked down and I was like, oops, cause and this swimsuit had like a zipper, it was like one of those body gloves.
Oh, that's a hot suit, man. I remember those.
I'm
going to tell you this. This is a weird story from years past, but it was like, it's the vision of it seared into my brain. We used to go swimming over at some friends of ours from the church. They had a pool. I'll tell you who it is afterwards. They had two daughters. One was a couple years older, but I remember she would lay by the pool, and I would go over there and go swimming, and I would always make sure I came up like right by where she was like sunbathing and shit. And I remember...
Little perv.
I remember getting up out of the fucking pool the one time, and she could tell she was just going through puberty. She's just turning into a woman, right? And you could see like the fucking pubes starting to fucking flow out from the sides of her fucking bathing suit. It was like, whoa, dude.
Yeah, I never let that happen. We started shaving that fucking shit as soon as we saw it.
I remember this vividly. To this day, I could probably draw it. It's like the first time you see that shit, you know? The sun was just hitting it just right. It wasn't like dark. It was like this, you know, blonde. It was like you saw these fucking hairs.
He's thought about
and
it
shit.
Once or twice, hasn't he? Yes, he has.
I figured out what I can jerk to now and get off.
Literally. All right, everyone.
All right, final word time.
I guess I gotta go find a cock ring. Find cock rings.
Cock rings is where it's at, man.
Definitely not long johns.
Yeah.
I mean, it makes my John long. But
you're wearing more than that girl was wearing, though, with her backpack fully covered.
I'd be better off than her, let's say, that much, yeah.
We're all better off.
Yeah, we are. I'm a kid, this is Goin Deep Show. Appreciate you guys hanging out with us, doing what you do. We encourage you to hit the GDS.com. and have some more fun with us. We'll see you guys soon. Chill to the next one.